Good afternoon. My name is Shane Anderson. I'm a teacher here at my school, and I am the MC for this afternoon's graduation ceremony. Welcome, everyone, to Gimli High School's 2023 graduation. We begin our celebration as we begin every day here at Gimli High School, acknowledging the traditional territory on which we gather. We acknowledge the traditional territory that Gimli High School resides upon is Treaty 1 and the homeland of the Red River Métis. We honor our partnership with Indigenous peoples and respect the gifts of history, culture, and language of Canada's original peoples. We commit to moving forward in partnership with Indigenous peoples and communities in the spirit of collaboration and reconciliation. A little bit of housekeeping for any family members or community members that weren't able to attend this afternoon. All our ceremonies this morning as well will be live streamed. The link will be available on the Gimli High website as well as on Instagram. The grads are going to enter in a moment. The procession will come in along the back, and they will assemble in front of the stage. When they're assembled in front of the stage behind me, Oh Canada will be played while the grads are on from the stage, and then they will move their assigned seat on the risers after the anthem. We are extremely lucky to have a professional photographer today. Mr. Kasulka is running around capturing all the moments from today's ceremony, and these are all going to be shared with the families at a later date, so feel free to sit back, relax, and just bask in the wonder of these young people. Because we've changed our setup a little bit, the traditional baby picture slideshow will also be shared online on this website and Etsy. The beautiful flowers that you see up in the front will be given away as prizes at the conclusion of the grad ceremonies. So tomorrow, there's going to be a winner from this ceremony and a winner from the morning ceremony, and we'll let you know tomorrow if you're coming to pick up some flowers. At this time, I would like to invite you to rise if you're able for the processional, and remain standing for the playing of the program.
We were underground, loaded merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside the merch lab. I just wanted my name to stop. Cause like where we at, still growing.
Thank you.
here. Maybe always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments where you ever miss what it's about. We're scared of the future, thinking about the past. So I'm missing out on that. We've come so far.
We gather today to celebrate the graduating class of Gimli High School for the year 2023. Graduation is one of the things that I love the most about teaching, is I get to, with the rest of the staff, have a final moment with our students. Get to reflect and remember all the wonderful moments that have gotten us to this point in here today. And I think we'll say goodbye and good luck, because you achieve what we gather here every day to do. A graduation ceremony is a moment in the present that has connections to the past and the future, a as we savor this moment, we celebrate where our past as students has brought us, and we sit excited with the promise of the future outside the walls of Gimli High School. Allow me to comment on the past, if you will. Families, friends, staff, and graduates in particular, let's just think about for a second what grade 9 and grade 10 was like. That's right, I paused for us to laugh, and then nobody did. As I likely said to you numerous times in those years, I actually considered growing my hair back just to be able to pull it out. But as you spent time driving me and all of us crazy, I felt that there was something special about your class. Ms. Bauer called it actually way back in grade 9, as we were discussing how close to the edge you guys had pushed me one day. She said, just watch, this will become one of your favorite classes that you've ever taught. I can confirm that she was not wrong. Class of 2023, thank you for the honor of not just helping send you off today, but for being part of your journey and becoming the fine new people that we're celebrating today. So let's get this formal part of this thing going and get you graduated, eh? To begin with, the first part of our program, we're going to have our green school division. And our superintendent, Mr. Scott.
Thank you to family and friends for being here today. Thank you to our staff. Congratulations, graduates. I'm pleased to bring greetings from the school division and the board of trustees. From my seat, it's a day to reflect on what we try to accomplish in our schools. For our students as individuals, yes, but also for our collective future. In Evergreen Schools, we talk about learning today to improve tomorrow. We talk about helping students learn to become contributing citizens in a democratic society. The land acknowledgement is also a reminder of what we try to do, and that is to learn to live with and among one another in good ways. For the better part of the past 50 years or so, I've been having conversations with people about what it really means to be an educated person. The same things come up over and over when people of any age category talk about this. It turns out, we mostly share a belief that educated people are those people who demonstrate these kinds of traits. They're caring, they're curious, they're open-minded, they try hard, they bounce back when things get difficult. They know some things about how the world works. They're courageous and compassionate. They're reflective about how to be with others, and they remember where they've come from. They're thoughtful about who they are becoming. These are just some of the common attributes that people share when they try to describe what it means to be an educated person. And folks, I'll bet that many of these descriptions fit for this group of young graduates here today. If that's true, can you confirm by applauding them? Now, I should say that schools are just one part of this picture. We know that. People become educated in all kinds of ways outside of school and through the influence of family, friends, the community, workplaces, travel experiences, through books and poems and music and movies and so on. So grads, please take a moment today to be grateful for all the people here who have helped to educate you. For our part, graduates, we've tried to make your school experience one in which you were able to make many mistakes in a safe place among people who care about you and for you to learn from those mistakes. I hope that you each had a chance to make a few mistakes. And I won't ask for applause from the rest of you to confirm that they did. This ability to safely make mistakes and learn from them might get a bit trickier as you move into adulthood. Without a group of people like this group that's surrounding you today. I don't say that to be melodramatic. I tell you because it's important that you keep or grow a group of people around you who do truly care about you. And I also tell you because it's important for you to be part of someone else's group of caring people People like to quote this author, his name is Robert Fulghum, when they talk to grads. He wrote a book called All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. And one lesson he recites is this one. When you go out into the world, hold hands and stick together. So maybe this part starts for you today and this evening. Maybe that's the part that you're most looking forward to. So for that part, I say, please stay safe and please have lots of fun. Congratulations, graduates of 2023.
Thank you, Mr. Bill. The next part of our graduation ceremony will be calling this group to the stage to address the class of 23.
I'd like to begin my speech today with a very fitting quote I saw on the backstage. For a graduation day such as this, from Lin-Manuel Miranda, he said, "My dear terrified graduates, you are about to enter the most uncertain and thrilling period of your lives." Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome everyone here, honored guests, staff of Gimli High School, parents, family, and friends. I thank you for joining us on this special day. This also is the best opportunity to welcome Mr. Scott Hill, the superintendent of Evergreen School Division, the attending Evergreen School Division trustees, Gladys Kohler, Jillian Yorga, and Penny Robinson. Thank you so much for coming. And most importantly, welcome to the students that are on this stage in this moment. It is with great pride that I look across at you, our soon-to-be graduates of Gimli High School for the year 2023. This is a wonderful day, one that I look forward to sharing with you all year long. In 2017, I made a commitment that each year, when I came up to do this graduation speech, it would be a tribute to the students that are on this stage, and that the speech would include a little something about each of the grads. So please accept this as my tribute and toast to the grads of 2023. To our adult students, who will receive their high school diploma after some hard work to get to this point, Sydney and Connor, it takes a lot of determination to follow through with your plans, so I want to thank you both for sticking with your goals and earning that diploma. To our graduates, Sophia, Brady, Liz, Leif, and Adam, I would like to thank you for your dedication to the success of today's graduation event. I want to share that this has been one of the best ever group of graduates that I've worked with over the years. They took the job seriously, followed through when needed, worked well together, and got tasks done on time. It was definitely a job well done, so thank you again. To those of you with artistic flair, Veronica, Amanda, Haley, and Emma, I'm not so sure if it was about the art or if it was more about your desire to hang out with Ms. Giardino, but we wish you good luck in your future ahead. To those of you who will go out into the workforce with a great deal of practical experience, Aiden, Jackson, Matthew, and Jacob, the skills that you learn through internships, apprenticeships, and paid work credits will be valuable tools for you. You are and will hold down a successful job moving forward. To our musicians, Brianne, Joe, Sophia, and Liz, if you were able to make it to either of our band concerts this year or the Jazz at the Dock event, you would know how awesome these young musicians are and how hard they work to sound as professional as they do. They represent a wonderful group of students leaving the GHS band family, and they will be sorely missed. To our mechanics, metal workers, and carpenters, Alex, Owen, Gear, and Deanna, the projects that you created and worked on in the shops were pretty stellar. Mr. Michalek and Mr. Wallach definitely saw a lot of growth in each of you, most of you since grade 9. You should be proud of your accomplishments in this area. To one of our worker bees, Brady. This is a student that we saw daily learning important skills that help to keep our school clean. What a great job you did. I commend you for your hard work, and we thank you for helping to make our school such a great place to be. our stellar academics, Sophia, Owen, Noah, Kieran, Brady, Lee, Jacob, Liz, and Anna. We will miss your hardworking attitudes and the way in which you model for others how to be a great student. As you graduate post-secondary, the skills that you acquire here will surely pay off there. To our athletes, Owen, Noah, Tanner, Tucker, Kaden, and Hugh, your dedication to the school teams and your leadership skills have been apparent since you entered our school in grade 9. Mr. Heminger, Ms. Burns, and all of your coaches will truly miss you. To our quiet group of students, Alexis, John, Becca, and Neely, you expressed your voice when needed and stepped up to get your high school career successfully complete. I know you will continue to do this in the future as you make a great life for yourself. Congratulations on a job well done. And to those looking for adventure, Austin, Abby, Jack, whether you hope to travel or take some time off before heading to university, may you fulfill your dreams wherever life might take you. And I think I got everyone, and maybe even some of you a couple of times. So to all of the graduates of 2023, on behalf of the staff at Gimli High School, I wish you well as you move forward in life after high school. Life will not always be easy, but our hope is that we have supported you in becoming educated enough to choose wisely whatever career you are passionate about, resilient enough to deal with the adversities that life is sure to throw you away, and thoughtful enough to use your talents and skills to become the best person you can become. My parting words to you today are included in a quote from Reba McIntyre, which she says this: to succeed in life, you need three things: a wishbone, a backbone, and a funny bone. So get out there and wish upon your star. Be strong enough to make good choices and have some fun along the way. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Green. The next part of our ceremony is the formal presentation of the diplomas, graduate tributes, awards, and scholarships. This portion will be conducted by Mrs. Groot, Mrs. Sankochik, Mrs. Levatt, Ms. Lavely, Ms. Bauer, and Ms. Griffiths.
Must include English and math. And lastly, called up to the stage only once for the presentation of diplomas, scholarships, and awards. When your name is called, please walk to the stage and stand underneath the GHS archway. As you approach the stage, a personal note will be shared about you. If you are receiving scholarships and or sports awards, this will also be summarized at this time. For clarity, students who are named on the All-Star Athletic Team are representative of athletes who show dedication to their team, are coachable, demonstrate sportsmanship, and through their efforts and abilities are difference makers on their team. Once your scholarships and awards have been announced, you will then face Mrs. Fruit for the presentation of your scholarship and diplomas, which will be presented as one package. Audience, please hold your applause until all scholarships and awards have been presented. Upon presentation of your diploma, please face Mrs. Ankocha, who will flip your tassel from right to left to represent your status as a high school graduate. And finally, before returning to your seat, please pause for a picture. We have a professional photographer on site to capture these special moments. For those graduates who are receiving scholarships and awards, after the ceremony, Mr. Nickerson and Ms. Giardino will be directing you to go to the designated area, which is the music room, for a photo meet and greet with your scholarship donor. Are there any questions?
Don't let anybody dull your sparkle.
Sophia is receiving the following scholarships and awards. The BBP Music Scholarship for being a member of Band 40S and demonstrating a willingness for musical growth. The Vincent Boulay and Podolchuk families sponsor this $300 scholarship. The University of Manitoba Chown Centennial Scholarship for being the best all-around student, having a high academic average of 85% per career, and will be attending the University of Manitoba in the amount of $1,000. The Robert Armisen Memorial Scholarship for her natural talent, commitment to community service, and strong work ethic. Robert was a teacher and principal of Gimli High School and later elected as a school board trustee for Evergreen School Division. He will be remembered as a kind, caring, and humble man with a great sense of humor, inspirational educator, dedicated community member, and exceptional role model. On behalf of the Armisen family, Sophia is being awarded with a scholarship in the amount of $1,000. The West Shore Community Foundation Scholarship for her high potential for success, academic grades, and volunteerism in the amount of $500. The Schooley Johnson Scholarship for Excellence in Mathematics is awarded to a student who will attend the University of Manitoba and earn the highest academic achievement in Math 40S. Schooley Johnson immigrated from Iceland in 1888, taught Latin and Islamic throughout his career, and served as the head of the Department of Classics at the University of Manitoba until his death in 1956. Sophia is being awarded a scholarship in the amount of $1,025. University of Manitoba, Queen Elizabeth II Entrance Scholarship in the amount of $3,000. In addition, Sophia has been named a member of the Athletic All-Star Team. Sophia is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction.
Eric Johnson.
and Citizenship Scholarship for achieving high academic standing, community service, demonstrating leadership, and the ability to communicate in public. This $200 award is given to a graduate from the Gimli constituency. Manitoba School Boards Association Students Leading Change Scholarship for her passion to lead and inspire positive change in her school community in the amount of $500. Royal Canadian Legion Gimli Grant Number 181 Scholarship, which is awarded to the child, grandchild, or great-grandchild of a veteran or eligible member in the amount of $500. The Valley Fiber Comstream Award for her community service and involvement in technology and video studies in the amount of $500. Brianna is graduating with an Evergreen School Division Diploma with distinction.
Joseph Dahl.
is found even in the words of Winston Churchill, "Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." Joe is receiving the following award. In recognition of his sportsmanship and athletic character, Joe is receiving the Jerry Barnes Award as a player of the varsity boys volleyball team. Joe is graduating with a Manitoba diploma. Congratulations, Joe.
Can you describe
described his time in athletic will fondly remember the first basketball season at GHS when he improved and grew as an athlete. He plans to go to the U of M and is keeping his specialty options open for now. Tanner hopes to one day explore Europe. Tanner is graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction.
Graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction.
all of us remember when she broke her foot in female fitness. Amherst is leaving GHS to pursue agriculture at the University of Manitoba. She leaves us with the following words: everything happens for a reason. Amherst is receiving the following scholarships and awards: RM Gimli Award for attaining outstanding academic performance and being actively involved in school and community service work. This $500 award is presented to a graduate who resides within the municipality. The Royal Canadian Legion Gimli Grant Number 181 Scholarship, which is awarded to the child, grandchild, or great-grandchild of a veteran or eligible member in the amount of $500. Amherst graduating with an Evergreen School Division diploma with distinction.
School.
more country music concerts. Brady is graduating with an individualized Manitoba diploma.
Grab it.
Baseline Foundation Margaret Davidson Memorial Scholarship for high academic excellence, involvement in extracurricular activities, and participation in community service work in the amount of $600. Evergreen School Division Award, in recognition of his academic achievement, community service, citizenship, and healthy lifestyle, choices in the amount of $500. Gimli Lutheran Centennial Scholarship, awarded to a deserving member of the Gimli Lutheran Church congregation with high academic achievement in the amount of $500. Life Touch Canada Award, in recognition of his significant contributions to the organization and planning of graduation day, in the amount of $250. University of Saskatchewan Veteran Scholarship, in the amount of $2,000. Adam is being recognized as a varsity boys golf and cross country MVP for his leadership and dedication to his team and the sport. In addition, Adam has been named as a member of the athletic all-star team. Finally, in recognition of his all-around athletic accomplishment and dedication to his team's success, Adam has been named Grade 12 Male Athlete of the Year and will receive the Joey Roach Memorial Trophy.
And I wouldn't have wanted to spend 12 years with any other group. Not only is our grad class hard working, we're kind of running. I will remember every single one of the friendly faces when I came into Gimli High School. Every individual that takes part in making the 2023 grad class is an approachable, respectful young adult who is bound for success. As we blossom into the young adults we are today, I would like to remind everyone of where we came from. Individuals like Hugh Spainson dancing away before his first ever volleyball tournament, or the extremely talented people who are involved with jazz orchestra rocking away the dog. And we can't forget Mark Person, who will always be remembered by his bright smiles no matter the time of day. Brady Sewell will remind me that he is going to achieve a Dodge TRX one day. In the words of Brady, four track, yeah. In Gimli High School, I can reflect on the amount of pride we have when it comes to athletics. This year, members of this grad class got a total of 5 zone high banners, including medals in track and badminton. All of the athletes that represented not only our grad class, but Gimli High School did a fabulous job. The beginning of high school was definitely a struggle. 13 beach kids had to find a way to be accepted into the existing dynamic. Kicking off our high school experience with the pandemic was also a great challenge. Online learning every day until summer wasn't easy, but knowing our grad class, we rose to the occasion. After thriving through the pandemic, I can officially say that the grad class of 2023 was one of the most active grad classes of all time, and I'm not just saying that because I'm a part of this class. Everyone that is sitting upon this stage today is an active member of this community, whether it's involvement with work, athletics, extracurricular clubs, or focusing on being that academic weapon, we aren't lazy, and that is a huge accomplishment in itself. Mastering the use of determination in high school is an achievement to behold, and every single member of our grad class is done this. Therefore, I am so very proud to be a member of the class of 2020. we managed to get by. So let's soak it in and enjoy our last few moments together. We would like to end off with these words from Eric Hansen. There is freedom waiting for you on the breezes of the sky. And you ask, what if I fall? Oh, but my darling, what if you fly?
Congratulations to the gods that you congratulations to the graduating class of 2023.
We are just about to.
A couple of little things before we wrap up. Students, when you're leaving the stage, you'll come down. You'll go back to where you stood at the beginning. And then we'll pause for a picture. We'll toss the hats. When we toss the hats or if we leave anything on stage, don't worry about it. We've had years dealing with stuff that lost and found. We'll get it back to you. Award winners, you're going to pop back to the band room for a photo with the presenter of your award. And that is about it. Class of 2023, your high school journey is complete. We've delivered our last lessons and we're sending you out into the world to make us proud. So, if you'll make your way down to the stage. Everybody got the picture. Some people are getting it now with me in it. Ladies and gentlemen, friends, family, everyone, your graduating class of 2023.